So before we jump into Simulink and see the practical implementation of PID, let us have an overview of what a PID does. So PID is basically a control method that generates a control input which drives a plot such that the actual output of the plot becomes equal to the desired output, which is also known as the reference. And it does so by taking the difference between the desired output and the actual output as its input. And that difference is known as the error term. So the input generated by the PID has three terms. The first term is the proportional term, which takes action on the current error, and it does so with the aid of the proportional gain, Kp. The second term is the integral term, which sums up the error over time and takes action on it using the integral gain, Ki. And finally, we have the derivative term, which forecasts subsequent error and then takes action on that using the derivative gain, Kd. So now let us go to Simulink and see what we have just discussed. So here we are in Simulink. I'm going to work with this plan. Gs is equal to 1 over s squared plus 5s plus 2. And as you can see, we have two control inputs. We have already discussed the first one, and later on in the video, we'll see where the second one applies. So basically, this is our feedback control loop. We have three parts for the PID as we earlier on discussed. So the difference between the reference and the output is the error term. And as you can see, the error term is multiplied by Kp in order to obtain the proportional term. And then the error term is integrated and then multiplied by Ki in order to obtain our integral term. And then finally, the error term is differentiated and then multiplied by Kd in order to obtain our derivative term. So the summation of these three terms gives the control input that is generated by the controller, which drives the plan such that the output becomes equal to the reference. So for this system, we assume that our actuator has a limit of minus 10 to 10 volts. Now let us start with our tuning. So advisably, always you shall start by keeping Kd as 0 and then tune your Kp and Ki. So as you can see, I have my Kp is equal to 1 and Ki is equal to 1. So if I run my simulation, so as you can see, the actual output, which is in red, has finally settled at the reference output, which is in blue. But however, it is a bit sluggish. But if we look at our control input, you can see the control input generated by the controller throughout is within our limit. It has not exceeded even 3 volts. So it means we can increase our gain so as to increase the input given to the actuator such that the response of the system becomes faster. Let me increase both Kp and Ki. So after running it, so if we look at the response, now it is a bit faster, but there is an overshoot. But still, it is a bit sluggish. I can make it faster because I'm still within the range of my actuator. So for example, if I increase my Kp to 10, so as you can see, it is almost at 10, so I'm about to exceed my limit, but it is a bit faster. The overshoot has decreased, but there is still a bit of overshoot, so I can introduce my derivative gains so as to reduce the overshoot. So now, as you can see, the overshoot is almost eliminated. If I make it 1, so it is almost eliminated. However, you can see the input is increased to almost 1 times 10 to the power of 14, which is far, far beyond my actuator limit. And that is a consequence of what we know as derivative kick. A derivative kick occurs when there is a sudden change in reference. So if you look at the reference at the output, initially they are all at 0 before there is a sudden change of the reference from 0 to 1. So this sudden change in reference also makes the error to suddenly change from 0 to 1, and that change occurs instantaneously. So differentiating that reduced to what is known as derivative kick, which is a huge input introduced into the system. So one of the methods of preventing that is using the second implementation. So the second implementation, the second U of T here, is one of the solutions for derivative kick. So instead of differentiating the error, now you are differentiating the actual output, and the positive value here is made negative. In order to solve that, we can just remove the error here, and then we differentiate the actual output. And the sign here, instead of positive, it will be negative. So now, if we run it again, so as you can see, still we have removed the overshoot and we have zero CD state error, and now our input is within limits. So we have an inbuilt PID controller block in Simulink. So if I just import it, if we double click on it, within it we also have the proportional gain, the integral gain, and derivative gain. So this is the implementation, as you can see. However, the derivative term, as you can see, is complemented with a filter which avoids the sudden change in reference. So let me just put the gains that I already obtained. So for example, this one to 10, this one to 4, this one to 1. And if I apply OK, then I will remove this one, the one that we already have here. I'll bring the inbuilt PID block and then connect it. So now if I run my system again, so as you can see, the performance is good. However, the control input is above 100, which means my solution for derivative kick is more effective than the one within the PID block. Simulink has the feature of automatically tuning your PID. So all you need to do is double click on the block. Then you have the tune button here. So if you press on tune, it will open up the PID tuner tab. As you can see, we have the tuned response in straight line, and we have the block response in dashed line. So this one is the tuned response, and you can tune your controller using these sliders. The first one is tuning the speed of your response, while the second one is tuning the robustness of your response. So I want it to be highly robust, and I want it to be a bit fast. So let me just adjust it a bit, just to prevent overshoot. So I think this one is okay. So the parameters, as you are moving the slider, the parameters will be updated here. And if you obtain a satisfactory response, you just click on update block, and the gains will be updated in your PID block. So you then close, and as you can see, the gains are updated here. I just click OK and then run my system again. So you can see now I'm within the limit of minus 10 to 10, and still I have a good response, a good tracking, and no overshoot. So if you want to learn how to implement this type of block in Simulink, export data from Simulink to MATLAB, and acquire more skills in Simulink, watch the video on the screen. Please like and subscribe to the channel if you learned something.